Major General Liam Tobin was a man who believed in and fought for many things. But one thing he dedicated his life for many years to fight for was the battle for Ireland's freedom from Britain. Liam Tobin, to me, was not just a soldier or a freedom fighter. He was family. More specifically, my great cousin, twice removed. Born in Cork, Ireland in 1895 to Mary Agnes and David Tobin, his family moved from town to town throughout his childhood until they finally settled in Dublin. While in Dublin, he took up work in his father's hardware shop as an apprentice until the 1916 Easter Rising took place. The Easter Rising was an armed rebellion that took place during Easter week in 1916 in Dublin. The goal was to end British rule in Ireland. Unfortunately, Britain succeeded, and many Irishmen who fought that day were either killed or imprisoned. One of those imprisoned was Tobin himself, who was at first sentenced to death. Somehow, though, he had his death sentence commuted to life and was released early in 1917 for unknown reasons. After his release, Tobin was still committed to the fight for Ireland's freedom, and that's when he joined the IRA as an intelligence officer, serving under Michael Collins, who was the leading patriot in the fight against Britain, and at the time, Ireland's most respected man. In 1919, Tobin became Collins' chief executive in the Intelligence Directorate, gathering information from informants on British officials' whereabouts, and being involved in the assassinations of members of the British government, British soldiers, informants, MI5 operators, members of the Irish police, and so forth. Throughout the years, Tobin rose to become one of Collins' right-hand men. Tobin and Collins became so close that they even exchanged letters to one another, as well as Tobin traveling with Collins to the Irish Treaty delegation as a member of his personal staff. Unfortunately, in 1922, Collins, Tobin, and members of the Irish Army were ambushed by gunmen on a road in County Cork. And while Tobin and many of the soldiers survived, Michael Collins was unfortunately shot and killed on sight. His funeral took place in public a few weeks later in Dublin, with all of Ireland mourning his loss. Tobin was among the many of Collins' closest associates who attended the funeral. He couldn't help but feel somewhat responsible for not being able to save his life out on that road. Tobin continued to fight for Ireland throughout the years, eventually receiving promotions to Deputy Director of Intelligence and Director of Intelligence. Tobin didn't spend all of his years as a soldier. He was also committed to being a father and a husband. In 1929, he married Monica Higgins at the Church of the Holy Family in Dublin and had two daughters, Mary and Anne. Unfortunately, in 1963, Tobin's health declined and passed away with his family surrounding him. He was 68 years old. But after reading about his life, though, I felt deep down that he died feeling proud of what he did for Ireland all those years.